dumb me with a curtsy. It's the honey, all along. By it I thrive. Without it I recede, start to die. Thunder. My hand drops. I'll eat no honey. Chimes, chime, chimes. Because by earth's urgings over world's want, all's gathered up from the partial labor of value and need. From field, flower, bower, and stream, slow amber of every bee, gold's master hour and o'er, source of games, pleasure, commerce, and war, though no more. And without, without me, the only way my agony can now find sweetness. Maybe. I kneel down beside him, though his smile's so sad I can't help but tremble. Blur, my coldest sky, my fallen land. No more tears. Enough of tears. Turn for a deadlier wake. His careless hair soft upon my hands. His countenance, my quakes. Ringlets by which he still redeems, reconciles, and warns. Cold so paralyzing. Oh, hear my curving and pining king. Green eyes with flecks of gold. Free and never sold. Reproaching me, his bumbling girl, for this kiss now I couldn't hold, left gently upon his brow. For him the world spins, and to blow it away would forfeit all the world already loves of him. What resolving he always bends, what ending he always evolves. How here without he still, some way over with, consoles what I'd now devastate. And he's just curling on the snow. He relies on more. More relies on him. And I cannot destroy more. For I cannot destroy him. Ever. So let ice cavalcades gallop his hair, and though withering in wrath, all he cares enough for to let go, I'll spare. Except me. I'm already over too, retreating from this life. So he goes, I also go. Twist about, cross legs and ankles. Guard over him, winter's shock lending winter's fall quickly on my shoulders. There is no more way for us. Here's where we no longer occur. Where the mixed up, the ever unfixed, freezoids for the haddits, sad bits and nixed. No longer pairs. Gone. Dancing around, goofing on, not even valid. And cold alone, oh, cannot numb how I miss me with him. Beyond return. Beyond all starts. Sure, no picnic stinging for him all over again. Alone, too alive with all he still provides and risks, touches and assists. His green emits these blushing golds, tickling hill and meadow, brook and hedge, for swerves of peace, heart-rendingly open. All that these roams already keep of him, explosions of rough-legged hawks, mallards and crows, bighorn sheep charging by cottontails, wasps, milk snakes and toads, brook trout, badgers, ants, and clouders of cats. My wide, deer bounding by crickets, coyotes, beavers, while golden bears range and bald eagles rise. Him, him, him. Future winds imploring me to stay. But I'm no tomorrow. I'm no yesterday. Only ever contemporary of this way. I will sacrifice everything for all his season's miss of soaring. He, I sigh from the mountaintop. By him now, my only role. And for that freedom, spread my polar chill, reaching even the warmest climes. A warning upon the back of every life that would by harming Sam's play, ever wayward around this animal streak of orbit and wind. Awaken among these cataracts of belligerent ice. Me, and my justice, at once. The vengeance of my awful loss set free upon this crowded land. An old tear, violent for the delirium of ends. But to those who would protect him, frightened by such beauty and savage presence to do more, my cool cries will kiss their tender foreheads, and my tears will kiss their gentle cheeks. And then, if the kindness of their love, which only loving ever binds, spills my ear, for a while I might slip down and play among his folds so green. My barrenness, Sam's solitude, and all his patience now presumes. Luster of spring's sacred brood. By you, ever 16, this world's reserved. By you, this world has everything left to lose. And I, your sentry of ice, shall always protect what your joy so terrifyingly elects. I'll destroy no world so long it keeps turning with scurry and blush, fledgling in charms beating with dews, and always our rush, returning renewed. Everyone betrays the dream, but who cares for it? Oh, Sam, no. I could never walk away from you.